How colorblind people see the world. Everyone's heard about colorblindness. A significant number of global celebrities, such as Bill Clinton, Keanu Reeves, Mark Zuckerberg, and even Prince William, are known to be colorblind. But do you know what colorblindness is? Colorblindness, also known as color vision deficiency, is not a disease, but the decreased ability to see color or differences in color. Approximately every 1 in 12 men and 1 in 200 women are affected by it. So, there's a high probability that someone you know, a neighbor, or a co-student is colorblind. There are four different types of colorblindness. Each of them provides deficiency in different color shades. For a person with normal vision, it is hard to imagine what it is like to be colorblind and how people like this see the world. Which color do they see? Do they see any at all? What does it mean not to be able to see red? And so on. That is why we at Brightside prepared a visual comparison of all colorblindness types and put them together for your better understanding. Let's have a look together. People with normal vision usually see the world around them in these colors. However, people with deuteranopia, the first type of colorblindness, see the same picture like this. Deuteranopia is the most common form of colorblindness. Around 4.63% of men suffer from it and in many cases don't even realize it. It's clear from the photo that the colors have lost some of their brightness, especially with regard to green and red. And people with protanopia see these pencils like this. Protanopia is a less widespread form of colorblindness. Only around 1% of men experience it. All shades of green and red appear somewhat faded, and blue and yellow shades remain virtually unchanged. The third type of colorblindness is tritanopia, and they see colors like this. Though a very rare type of colorblindness, tritanopia affects both men and women to an equally small degree. Those who experience it see the world in greenish-pink tones. The last type is total color blindness. It is hard to imagine, but it exists. However, only a small percentage of people are affected by it. Only 0.00003% of the whole world's population. And now, let's have a look at the straight comparison. How about a piece of fruit? Normal vision. Deuteranopia. Protanopia. Tritanopia. And together. Impressive, isn't it? And now, traffic lights. It is widely known that people with color vision deficiency can have difficulties while driving. By looking at these pictures, you will understand why. Here is normal vision. That's deuteranopia. This is protanopia. And that's tritanopia. And together again. Quite an eye-opener. A popular soda label. Normal vision. Deuteranopia. Protanopia. Tritanopia. Together, my world will never be the same. What about a rainbow? Rainbow with normal vision. With deuteranopia. With protanopia. With tritanopia. Together. So Richard of York gave battle in vain. Indeed. Street traffic. Look at the streetcar. Normal vision. Deuteranopia. Protanopia. Tritanopia. Together. And now the final example. Frida Kahlo was a Mexican painter in the first half of the 20th century. Was she ever thinking about how her paintings could be seen by colorblind people? Well, we don't know about Frida, but you are going to see it right now. Normal vision. Deuteranopia. Protanopia. Tritanopia. And together. Beautiful. Are you still with us? Then here are some historical facts for you. Colorblindness as a vision deficiency was discovered by English chemist John Dalton after he realized that he was colorblind himself. In 1798, he published the first scientific paper related to this subject, which was called Extraordinary Facts Relating to the Vision of Colors. Due to his immeasurable input into the research of colorblindness, the general condition has been named after him and known as Daltonism. Though, as Wikipedia states, in English, this term is now used only for deuteranopia. Was this video interesting? Share your opinion in the comments below and hit the like button below the video. The more likes we get, the more videos we can make for you.